Hare Krishna. To be happy is possible. To be happier than others is impossible. We all want to be happy in life. And actually, we can be happy if we choose to be. But often our problem is that we want to be happier than others. And usually we imagine others to be happier than what we are. So that means not only happier than we are, we think that they are happier than what they themselves actually are. Because often people don't parade their distress. They often put on a smile when they are in public. And especially if they have the accoutrements of success. If they have the trappings of success, if they have wealth, they have power, they have position, then we think they must be happy. However, distress is universal in this world. And everybody has their own distresses. This world is Dukkhalaya, as the Bhagavad Gita says in 8.15. So when we compare ourselves with others, even if we temporarily feel ourselves better than others because, say, we have better looks than them or better wealth than, more greater wealth than them, or we are richer than them or whatever. But still, sooner or later, we'll find someone who is better than us. And our mind will obsess over those who are better than us in those particular respects and make us dissatisfied. So if we want to be happy, we have to focus on our own consciousness, not on comparing our condition with that of others. The Bhagavad Gita talks about how we can be happy when it talks about austerity of mind in the 17th chapter. In 17.16, it says that Manaha Prasada Saumyattvam Maunam Atma Vinigraha Bhava Samshuddhirityetad Tapomana Samuchyate. So, manaprasada saumyatvam, manaprasada, satisfaction of the mind. It's interesting, Krishna said this is austerity. That means he's saying that we try to be satisfied. How? By cultivating satisfaction, by choosing to look at the things that we have rather than the things we don't have. So, satisfaction is just not just an emotion, it can be a decision. And later on he says, so, Maunam Atma Vinigraha Bhava Samshuddhirityetad. So especially if we purify ourselves, if we purify ourselves of our greed, of our lust, of our envy, then we can get happiness. Of course, we can strive to acquire external things. But if we think that getting more external things than others will make us happy, we will sentence ourselves to perpetual unhappiness, because there will always be people who have more than what we have. So trying to be happier than others is a doomed pursuit. But trying to be happy is an eminently possible pursuit if we focus on looking at what we have and purging ourselves of the desires and cravings to look at the things that we don't have. And both of these happen when we spiritualize our consciousness by connecting with Krishna. When we connect with Krishna and we understand that we always have Krishna with us in our hearts, and when we, by increasing our devotion to Him, learn to find satisfaction in His remembrance, then we both get satisfaction, and because of the remembrance of Krishna, our heart gets purified of impurities. And thus, we can find happiness. We can find inner contentment. Thank you. Hare Krishna.